this is Morgan with Murals by Morgan. And today we have a real treat. We're going to teach you how to paint a landscape. I'm going to show you step by step. And with me today I have Chiara Spataro.
Help.
She came from Italy and we had this extra day because of the rain. So we thought we'd make a tutorial for you so that you can see how we do it, start to finish, and maybe get ideas for your room. This is for a girl's room. We're going to create an enchanted forest feel with a big oak tree in the corner, maybe a little bit of water, some really soft colors fading out so it fits in the room. But yeah.
Here we go. Yeah.
All right, we're gonna start out by preparing the wall by making sure that it's smooth. And Chiara, we've pulled off the baseboard and just make sure that all holes are patched and that you have a good solid foundation. Our next step is in chalk, using chalk in a different color. I'm gonna think through what I wanna put on the wall. So I'm gonna chalk out here that I want the trunk to come up, maybe coming on this wall a little bit. I'm gonna make the light source from right here. So this would be sort of where the light comes through to the mural. So I'm gonna think about that. I'm gonna think about where I want the ground to go, these flowers. The bed is about here. And I thought, wouldn't it be nice to have a little lake, a meadow, maybe even some hills in here. We'll see once we start painting what there's room for. I'm gonna go ahead and kind of block in. Maybe there's some oaks here with sunlight peeking through, some foreground flowers. So your second step after you prep the wall is to take a piece of chalk and think about what you wanna see on the wall. Not the colors, but where are the main elements, the tree or whatever the subject of the mural is. And you think about how you're gonna spread it out. And it's mostly for your head. You're not gonna follow these lines. You're just blocking it out so that you have a sense of what you're gonna create. It cements it. Because in the next step, I'm gonna take a roller and I'm gonna cover all this chalk. But it's just for me to kind of get a sense of where things are going. When I set up, I lay out my design images, put down a drop cloth. I have golden acrylic paints for the colors, but I start with house paints. These are Benjamin Moore Aura. I pour them into smaller containers so it's easy to mix. And I'm gonna start with a clean roller, start with my lightest color and work towards the back and cover the whole wall in paint. Okay, this is a nice soft blue color, huh? Darker. So this gets rid of the green by adding the red. Now Chiara is going to take a medium-sized brush, and while the paint is still wet, blend the colors together to soften them. So she's using a yellow, if it gets dry, to soften and lighten, and she's going to work quickly over all the areas to essentially create like a faux finish. And then we're going to keep going with the faux finish with a medium-sized brush. And we're just going to pop out some light areas and some dark areas. I went over with a purple medium brush. Chiara continued with the yellow, so things start to have more space in them. It's not solid. So I took those solid roller lines. This is solid right here. This is where the light might peek through the branches. So we're just going to do this here and there, And towards the bottom, it starts to peek out a little bit more. And right now we're still doing the base coat. This is just providing essentially a backdrop for the canvas for the detail work we're gonna do later. We're just starting out with building up some color. So there's no yellow, it's like we have control over the color we use. Now this is a little wet, so I might stop here. You see, I actually want this to be the sky, not necessarily leaves. So I'm looking for places where it's actually white, where I can start to work in the sky color. See that? That could be the bottom right there. Maybe right here there's a little bit of an edge. And maybe this could be the tree further back. I don't really know, so I haven't decided yet. So I'm just gonna do just this texture wherever I feel like it. Just keep moving around. And then that's a real dark area. I could put one or two little pieces of light in there poking through. But mostly I might go down here to the edge. Maybe this is gonna be the edge. We actually haven't decided yet. And that's still pretty wet, so I'm not gonna go too much. I would say don't spend too long in any one area. Don't get frustrated. Just let this be. Just enjoy it. This is the time where you put on music and you stop thinking too much and you don't worry about it. You more or less know where things are gonna go, and right now you're just covering the wall in different colors. And oops, you know, that's the wrong spot. Whoops, that's okay. It's no problem. We just keep going. Whoops. I like that. Whoops. Breaking up. If you see any lines for nature scenes, we want to avoid any lines. So there was like an edge of a roller here, so I thought I'd break that up a little bit more. Okay, and then I think we're gonna wanna do a lake here, so I'm just gonna go ahead and put in beginning. There's something right there. Maybe that's gonna be our lake, we don't know yet. Like a pond. Very calming if it's low. If you're gonna put in water, this is actually too low. But she's a little girl, so it's gonna feel nice and peaceful. Her bed is gonna go right below this. If you put the water line up here, you feel short. So that's why oftentimes, even the mountains, I put them lower. It feels good. My next step is I'm gonna paint in the base coat of the trunk. And again, this isn't exactly where the trunk is gonna go, but we're gonna do the background first. And so I'm gonna do some more trunk lines. We'll add more later, but I do the big stuff. And I like to start with a darker color. See, I picked this really deep purple, because then if the reds and the oranges or any other color, even light blue, it will pop out. So I'm still working in the darker colors, but I think I'm gonna clean up this line just a little bit. I'm gonna take a big brush. It's okay, it's not clean. It's a yellow, it's fine. We just, and I'm gonna mix some red in with the purple. Again, the red will help it differentiate from the green. And we mix it in with the purple. And maybe actually a bigger brush down here. So I'm just gonna work on these lines, you know, helping this. Where is this coming from? And make sure you get all the way down in the corners with this darker color. So you're gonna get all the way down there. And in fact, you know, since it's a girl's room, we're actually not gonna go too dark. This is, I think she didn't want so much drama. She wanted it kind of sweet and lighter. So we'll be going over this to lighten it up later. Chiara is going to start refining the edges with to match the wall color a little bit. So we get a really soft transition from the edge. So she's mixing together white and yellow. And she might move in later to a little bit of grayish blues or greens. But essentially we're going for a faux finish around the edge. So that whole edge will be super soft. So the last thing I want to do is just make sure that I've covered the wall, and there's some areas that I haven't covered yet, so I'm just going to continue with the brush to make sure that everything is covered. And as it gets closer to the horizon, and let's say this is a misty mountain, I'm going to get lighter, but let's just say this is a mountain in the background. Maybe it's this color blue. Okay, so we'll keep that color blue. This is going to be a tree, so it might have some peeking through. So we'll do some of this later, but let's just say that's there. And this is like, if you live in the Bay Area, maybe it's the Santa Cruz Mountains or just something dreamy that we'll put here. Then I'm actually going to go lighter as it moves up in the sky. And this blue, this is a nice grayish blue. It's not bright blue. You can go a little brighter, definitely, but it's softer for a bedroom. You know, it's happier to go brighter color, but I'm preferring, in general, I prefer lighter. So this might be the sky. Now, we might have tree leaves coming down on this. So maybe I want to leave some yellow here and there. Maybe this is some of the leaves. Maybe this is the sky. And we can pull out exactly where the mountain line is later. Again, we're just getting the paint on the wall. We're not worrying about if it's all in the right place or not yet. Some of that yellow, because we want to pop out in the end. Some of the yellow is going to be on the edge of the tree, so that's okay. And I could definitely use a smaller brush here so I could get a better edge. That's about it for the base coat. Now you should stop, let it dry. Go have a meal, relax, don't think about the mural for an hour. And then when you come back to it, you're actually ready to start paying attention to the details and make it really into a work of art. This is completely just to get paint on the background to build up the colors. Okay, now we had a nice rest and we come back to the wall. The paint is all dry and now we're ready to start painting. And I always like to do the background first and then work towards the foreground, because the foreground, we want it to pop out. And also I tend to work from the top down, because sometimes when you're working, you might get a drip. So I sort of decide between that. I think right now I'm gonna start with the background, and then I'm gonna work on the high areas, and then I'm gonna move to the low ground. Now, one of my best secrets is, in order to control the color, I often will use house paints if I want a dull color, because the artist acrylics are very bold and bright and it's hard to mix them with a lot of control, so they're very subdued. So actually for these background mountains, we want something misty and dreamy. So I've mixed up, this is that same house paint blue right here, and I added a little bit of this purple color in and a little bit of red in very subtly. And then I took the white and added a little bit of red to make pink and yellow. So basically these are house paints right here. And I'm just gonna use the house paints for this background area. And then we're gonna move on to the artist acrylics. And sometimes I use a little water to thin things out if I need to. So I'm gonna start with the horizon. I even brought some pink maybe for the clouds. And it's not so that the clouds are pink, but more so your eye can just see them a little bit. And actually I decided, I think this is a good height for the mountains. I'm not sure I want them this high, maybe a little bit higher. So maybe I will Oh, that's too pink, but that's all right. Maybe I wanted that pink, who knows? Keep it. But I have some yellow, so that'll soften it. And maybe there's just a little bit of sunlight right there. We'll see. And also, some of the tree is going to hang down over this, so it's not all going to be seen. But I just want to get a sense of where it is, so that's where I'm going to start. And then I'll work slowly upward, mixing in some blue. The blue is going to mix with the pink and make it just a little bit purple. That's okay. I like that. Maybe I'd feather this a little bit. Okay, so you just play with it. Now for the clouds, I think I want it pretty soft. So I'm doing a lot of longer brush strokes. I might switch to a larger brush. I really like these chip brushes because that way, you know, with a little water, too much, just a little bit, you can start to like really fade that in. So that's really soft there. And I can also, this is super fun, just add in a little bit of cloud cover, like maybe there's just a little bit of cloud that starts right there. Who knows? You know, just a little bit. It's kind of a cloudy day, I think, or it's kind of misty out, so we're not doing white clouds against blue, we're just keeping it soft. And then this is gonna have maybe peaks of the sky through it. We don't know. I'm just gonna put in a little sky over there. And then fading up to the blue. Over there, I think I'm not gonna put much of a mountain. And now I'm gonna put in some hills. Really soft in the background. Maybe you can see them there. And then slowly working in another color to make them just a little darker. So I'm mixing towards purple here.
Mm-hmm.
And I even like it when it blends with the sky just a little bit. So it's like, oh, did that mountain start there or not? I can't tell. Right, so, and then, you know, this is a little bit too green for my misty day, so now I'm gonna mix forward with some more purples. And then maybe a little more, and then I might start moving towards that greenish color just a little bit. And actually, I can even start to leave some of the purple to let the green show through. That's another good idea.
Mm-hmm.
Ah, and you know what? Something else maybe I want to do is there might be a reflection of this mountain in the pond down here. So maybe I'll start adding in a little bit, thinking about the sky here. And we can have some grasses grow up over this, but that would be really pretty. And maybe a little moving back towards the pink again. And it's not as sharp a color, so that these are a little muddier, that's okay. Because reflection isn't gonna reflect perfectly. On to the trunk. I'm gonna do the trunk second, and then have the leaves coming out over it or around it. Sometimes the trunk might be partially covered. So we don't know, but we know we wanna do this trunk. And the brightest color on the trunk is gonna be some moss. I think I wanna put some moss on the trunk. So I'm gonna start with a little bit of moss. So like here, right when it turns the corner, maybe we put a little moss. Kind of sits sometimes on the top of the tree. And this will help me like define the line of the trunk too. I noticed the moss on the edges, so we could make it growing around the front, but I think I'm just gonna keep it at the edges. And then down by the trunk, I was thinking maybe some more, maybe growing up from the bottom of the tree. So a little more mossiness. That's cool. Kind of gives it that dreamy feel she mentioned. I'm gonna keep mentioning that because
you know, when the client says, my client, she's 12 years old, when she says, I want something kind of dreamy, then I just keep trying to remember, what would this make it more dreamy? Would that? So then I can make sure it's close. Now this green is going to kind of disappear up there, but we're going to keep some highlights. We'll help it pop out later. So there we go with the moss. That's probably enough. We don't want to go overboard. Oh, down by the base, just a little bit. And I'm using a super bright green. We're probably not going to touch on this green again because it's so bright. But only crazy things like moss grow in this bright green color. Now I'm going to move on to darker colors for the trunk. Now I'm going to start mixing in some trunk. And I really like the roughness of some of these oaks around here. So, and this might be a light side right here. Like maybe the trunk goes back. So I'm going to pop that out with a little bit of light color. That's dark right there, but maybe there's a little bit of light hitting it here. It's turning a corner. So I'm just kind of thinking about it. I could even go lighter on some spots. I like charcoal-y colors. It doesn't have to be a black trunk. And maybe even here, there's like some areas that just get lighter. And then we can move darker. And, you know, I had this plan. I brought a little bit of this orangey color because I noticed outside when I went by, there was a big knot in the tree. And inside the knot, it was kind of a lighter color. So I thought, maybe we do that inside of the knot. And then like that. So we're going to start to build a knot there. And the other thing about the knot is, you know, on the outside, maybe it has. I'm going to start working that into being a knot. I don't know where it's going to go. All right, so now I'm just creating texture. This is part of the trunk. We don't need to go so dark all over the place. So, this is like a bluish color. I put this on my palette just to create something else to sort of look at besides it goes over the red well. So I'm just gonna do this all over the whole tree. I've got a smallish brush. I'm gonna add some branches, maybe in this darker color. All right, now what we've done is put in the trunk here and here, and I'm gonna start working top to bottom with the leaves. And what I wanna do is just, we have some base colors in that are good, is to pop out some of the leaves. The edges might be lighter and brighter. I've mixed together a palette of greens, and this is house paint, but I've mixed some red in with the green, some blue in with the green, some yellow. I've got a warmer color here, because a lot of times, you know, on a tree, there's some brownish branches or around the edge, it changes color. So, and I put some white on my palette. So I kind of have a lot of different colors to play around with. And I'm just gonna start to think about pulling out some colors. And the darker areas, I'm gonna work with some darker leaves. Maybe that's even too dark. I just keep mixing and adjusting. Maybe in the darker areas, I pull out like some greenish leaf. This has a bluish, that's what I meant to say, bluish here, like that. That's good, and then as it pulls out, it gets a little lighter in color, so maybe I do some of these coming out from this. And maybe there's a few leaves that go over the branches, so we might do that. And then coming down towards the edge, maybe I want some lighter ones. Maybe that's too light, but you know, I was thinking some of the tree is pretty much in the distance. So the canopy, some of it is coming towards you and some of it's coming away from you. So the part on the other side of the tree, Like, let's say this is the far side of the tree. I want to show a detail shot of how I take this base coat and create some light and dark places. So again, I want to emphasize that you don't want to completely lighten the dark areas. You kind of want to work with what's there, and you don't have to fill in every single spot. That's the beauty of having the green for the base coat. So this is one field of color with a few pops. And, you know, I could try this and say, well, that's a little too strong. But maybe towards the lighter areas, the green gets lighter, like this. That's just kind of a light area. Maybe I work around the branches a little bit. And then as I get closer to the darker, I'm going to move towards a darker color. This kind of works with, and I might go back over this green with this darker color in some areas too. Okay, then the branches get thicker right around here, so we'll let that happen. I just added a little one step darker here, and here I'm working into the darker color. So, you know, it's a shortcut to use this background. You don't have to be such a perfectionist, but as I work towards this darker color, It looks like it's lighter, but if I put it over here, do you see how dark it is? So you can put some in, it's fine, but in general, we don't want to lose the lighter and the darker areas. Because it creates more drama, it's easier for the eye to read having some dark areas and some light areas. And this gets really dark, maybe I'll add even this little reddish color in. And you see how I'm not filling in everything, but enough to give it the movement. Okay, so I'm just showing you how there's variety here. It's not all monotone. We're not doing all this color or all that color. I'm working through from a lighter to darker palette. And now that I'm here, I might go back to working with a yellower color. You know, start in a new area up here. This is actually, that's some warmth in it, which I like, which reminds me, I just paint, I'm like, oh yeah, I like the warmth. So let's add some warmer color in down here too. Maybe the sun shines through, or it's got a little dead branch back here. It's just adding in another color there. It's good to get away. I like to break up the greens. When I see another color like this, I think it makes it, for the eye, nice to look at instead of all greens. So I really do recommend, you know, whether it's just happy circumstance or whatever, you keep mixing back into some warmer colors here and there. Now that we've put in the green, well, there's two things that, well, the first thing, next thing we're going to do is put in a few flecks of light. So this is absolute color. This is light showing through the branches. Okay, so I'm going to take a small brush and just break up some of these areas just a little bit. And it makes it look like, you know, you've spent all this time on the brushes, you know, detailed brushwork, when really you're just painting back. And you want to make sure that it's dry, so you're not mixing in green. So this is an absolute color, and it gives a lightness to the greenery. So we want like that areas. And this area, like, it's not very defined. The light is actually going to peek through in cracks. And not all over the place. We're just picking out here and there a few areas, maybe around the branches here and there, so the branch can help, your eye can help find the branch just a little bit. And in the areas where it's really dark, it's fine. It pops out a little bit just to have a few dots. This one is already kind of light, so I'm just helping the eye see it. Okay? Now that we finished the top part, we're going to start working down. So I pretty much have a lot of branches in. Maybe at the end I'll pop a few things out, but for now I'm going to focus on this background going down. Okay, so let's start over here with the trees. I often use a chip brush on the background to get more done. On the foreground, I like the brushwork because you can see almost every single leaf, but in the background, you can't see every single leaf. So it's okay to to use a chip brush. So let's start on these trees here. And as you come towards the foreground, the things are a little darker. So around the top, maybe I have some lighter colors like this. And maybe there's some like this, and then I'm gonna move towards some darker greens here. And this purple is gonna help me. And I can because I don't have to fill it in completely. Some of that purple poking through is okay. And maybe towards the bottom, I'm gonna get even darker. And I can cover some of these up, these light points. There's that joke I made earlier. Okay, so that's more or less bringing in the trees. And then after that, I'll show you. We're gonna do some branches in each of the trees. And because the trees are gonna be shining in the water, actually, we want to get in those edges and continue down here. And we may not see the top of the lake. We don't know. I think I'm gonna put the lake right here. So who knows, but maybe we get a little bit of the tops of the tree down in this area. So maybe I'll put some. Okay, and I think right now, right about now, we have to decide where this lake line is. And the bottom half is going to become the reflection, and the part above will become the light. Let's do that now. And next we're going to decide where the lake is. And actually, because of the reflection, I'm going to go ahead and put a line up a little high and then turn the lower half into a reflection. So let's say our lake is right here, and it's better to use a level because you want the water is going to sit at a level angle. So that's going to be the beginning of our lake and of our pond or water. Sometimes it helps if you get down to eye level to see. Maybe there's some trees that interrupt it here, so we don't know how far it's going to go across, but maybe it doesn't go across anything. And then, to give it that feeling of water, with a thin brush, or you can actually use it, a chip brush. This is probably easier. You can start to put in a little movement from the lake so that everything doesn't have to be so perfect up top. But I'm going to wait. I'm actually going to wait on that idea because I'm going to do some of the shoreline here and have it reflect, and then we'll do the water again. And now I'm using my chip brush to create some color and a skyline here of the more foreground trees coming forward. And then I take that color while I'm working on it, and I also incorporate it into the water just a little bit so that it feels like there's a reflection into the water here. So I put a little bit of this purple. So I have a lighter color here, and then I'll just make sure that it shows up right down there. And another thing you can do, which ends up looking really nice, is to add a little bit of land, like the edge of the lake, and you can do that in purple, golden. And you can't see the edge of the lake, but you can see the so I'm doing this with a purple. Maybe right here there's just a little outcropping. And I'll put the white back through that I lost so that it reads well. And here, this could go into the lake a little bit. These trees. Now put some branches on there, and then we'll start to move down to the bottom. So the tree has some branches coming towards us, and some branches are going away. And I imagine that the ones that are going further in the background are going to be a lot softer. So I'm going to mix some of my really light yellow with some blue. And back in here, maybe there's just little parts of the tree hanging back. So this is all impressionistic back here. It's not super defined. I probably won't put branches, but I'm going to do that towards the background. So the tree doesn't look bare, because if we only do the foreground branches, it's going to look like it's winter. And we want it not necessarily to look like it's winter. So you can see those softer ones, but then in this corner, you see I have a dark start. I'm going to make it come out towards you. And the way I'm going to do that is by using brighter over darker. So maybe there's some branches coming here. And the leaves might be more defined. You see how those look more there in the foreground? And in the darker areas, maybe add in a little bit of blue. Just more contrast for the foreground leaves. Okay? So for the grasses, Kiara is working with the chip brush to create some background movement and transition. And then she's going to go over in a fine brush and put in a few details, but especially along the top, because we want a few flowers next to her bed. Okay, and then for the last step, I go along and I add just a little bit of flowers, pink, yellow, white. And it creates this delicate element in the foreground. I did a little bit of yellow and white for the highlights. That's just about it. I added a few highlights for the water, some birds and a duck. And now Ella has a beautiful scene to look at.
Hey Ellie, how do you like your new mural?
I really like how the sky is so pretty and the mountains just make me feel really peaceful, and I love the little ducks on the pond, and I just love falling asleep right next to a big oak tree. I love it. It's exactly what I was thinking about, like exactly what I had planned, and it's really peaceful and calming for me.
Hi, Kiara, you want to go for a picnic today?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I saw a nice tree over there. Maybe we can put out a picnic blanket.
Yes.
Thank you so much for joining us today. We hope that you learned something useful from watching us create this mural. We did this mural in one day. We started about, 6 hours ago or 7 hours ago, and here we are finished up. So anyway, I hope this inspires you to start your own mural. And Kiara, thank you for coming from Italy to come paint with me today.
Oh, thank you, too.
Okay, bye.